is unclear. State Senator Fred Risser is one of the fugitive Democrats. He joins me in Edie Hill now from an undisclosed location. Senator, thank you for taking this enormous risk, appearing on TV. They may swoop in and arrest you any moment, but so far you're surviving.
I don't consider it a risk.
All right, well, that's glad you're not at risk. Let me actually throw the first question at you, because, you know, I poked around in your state's constitution for a few minutes this afternoon, and I'm not asking to be or hoping to be retained by you guys, but there's a provision here, Article 4, Section 15, that says members of the legislature shall, in all cases except treason, felony, and breach of the peace, be privileged from arrest, and then it continues on. So have you committed treason? Is that what they're saying?
All that was done was a Senate resolution was passed. And we pass hundreds of those resolutions every year. Anyone with the slightest knowledge of civics knows that to become law, a bill must pass both houses of the legislature and be signed by the governor. There's no violation of any law here. There are no court orders out. I can't believe that the Wisconsin law enforcement officers are going to spend much time trying to look us up.
I don't think they will. In fact, the union, the police union chief was saying he thinks it's insane to even do that. But let me ask you, I'm guessing one of the basic functions of your job is to show up to work. And I'm just wondering, do you think it's professional how you're behaving?
Well, we're going to come back. We're not staying out indefinitely.
Well, you stayed out a long time. When are you coming back?
Well, the purpose of going out was to slow the matters down. The governor introduced a bill on Monday that he expected under suspension of the rules to pass on that week. You know, you don't repeal collective bargaining and workers' rights in less than a week, rights that have been accumulated over 50 years.
Yeah, but, sir, respectfully, you're not slowing things down. You've stopped them.
Our purpose was to slow things down, to give the public a chance to react to the governor. And that has happened. Over 100,000 peaceful demonstrators have been around the Capitol, made known their opposition. I think that this should have an effect on our Republican colleagues, and hopefully they should tell their governor that maybe he should represent all the people of the state rather than just the right-wing zealots.
Look, Senator, here's how it shakes out in my mind. At least, look, I'm not thrilled that you've gone across state lines, but I view it as something akin to what the United States senators in Washington did, using the filibuster, using the rules as aggressively as they could to stop bills from being voted upon when they disagreed with them and didn't have the votes to defeat it but could stop the process. It's the way the system works right now, and we got to try to get beyond it somehow. Let's move to the substance for a minute. Is there any progress being made bridging this gap? I'm with you. I think this is the wrong thing to do substantively, the wrong way to do it. The public is with you, by the way. The public opposes what the governor's trying to do out in Wisconsin. But is any progress being made in a negotiation?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. The Democratic senators, even though they're out of state, they've been spending quite a bit of time talking about to their Republican colleagues in the Senate. And yes, I think that there has been progress made, and I think that we'll be returning in a reasonable time to act on matters. But our job was to try to slow this process down, give the people a chance to realize what was going on. It's a